Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ShadowFury333, and we're about to fight the only other boss I was spoiled on. Although, like I said before, I did co-op fight Dancer of the Frigid Valley, but that's, I think, much later in the game. So, for now, this tree thing over here. Yep. Also, before I start, I will point out, for the sake of transparency, I did actually, between episodes, I mean, obviously, we just jumped here, for one thing, because I didn't want to have to bore you with a run back. Nor will I. I mean, I'll add it back if I have to. But also, I did upgrade my crossbow to +2. Turns out you cannot raw upgrade ranged weapons at all, or magic implements. In Dark Souls 2, that was a bit of an exploit, honestly. I mean, you could have raw crossbow, but why wouldn't you? Because raw is just extra damage with no scaling. And then you could also, I mean, the talismans were a bit, or chimes rather, were a bit different because they were both dark and miracles. So lightning for miracles and dark for hexes rather. So that made a bit of sense, but yeah, that's not in 3. In 3, you can only do stone upgrades or infusions on melee weapons, not ranged weapons, not magic implements, only melee weapons. And now, without any further delay, go after this boss. Right, so a bunch of worshippers. Oops. Huh, interesting. So just regular. Come on. There's just regular. Ah, okay, there we go. I was wondering. Okay, when is going to be the actual boss fight? The answer is now. I also bought a few more bolts. Wow, that upgrade was worth it. I mean, really, that was a lot of damage. I think it was 60-something before, and now it's 84. So I'm pretty impressed. Hopefully there aren't more little enemies coming out. Yep, there are. Looks like the tree kills them too, so awesome! Oops. Okay, forget lock-on. What the heck? Okay. Ow. Interesting. So it's thrown down a little sap, I guess. Got hammers to deal with. So it looks like it will be spawning new enemies over time. Oh no, it's not. Okay. What the heck? Alright, so we have. You got hand stuff, right? No, you don't have hands. There we go. What? Well, that's great. Pretty good time for that, I gotta say. But where are the polyps need to attack? There are the polyps need to attack. Ow! At least I hit it. Man, these enemies are annoying. Not sure how I think about this, although I do like that Dark Souls 3 is a bit better at dealing with this sort of thing than 2, but this was one of the sins that 2 was committing, which was essentially forcing you to fight a large amount of enemies while fighting a boss at the same time. I guess it's not as bad as that. What was that one fight? It was a fight in the Brightstone Coast Eldora. It was a big priest or something, and this is going to stomp on me, isn't it? Yep. I tried to roll out of the way. I failed to do so. I think I have time. I do have time! Awesome. Wow, this is going to be a long fight, I can tell. Ow! Sheesh. I don't remember what it was called. Oh, wow! Do I get free shots? No, I just get a bit of respite. And, oh, I didn't kill the enemy? What the heck? There we go, now it's dead. What? Oh, you're not dead. Okay, no longer targeting you. So we've gotten rid of one of the big polyps. It looks like it really is just a matter of hitting those big limb polyps, the ones on the limbs. Hit those. Thank you. If I break them, yeah, there's the massive damage. All Whoa! I didn't expect that one is also to be massive damage. Oops. And down we go. Please don't hurt me. Okay, good. Didn't hurt me. Oh. Okay, now what? Are you gonna stomp me? You're gonna try. You're not gonna succeed. How the heck? You know, you'd expect a sword to be able to cut wood. Apparently no. Okay. How am I supposed to hit this thing? I can't change targets. Ah, seriously, I can't change targets? That'd be nice. It was in Bloodborne, wasn't it? You could change what part of an enemy you were targeting. That was extremely handy. And I'm basically having to shoot crossbow from the hip because that's how you do this thing, apparently. Okay, is it gonna collapse backwards? Now, honestly, once the... I mean, I probably am speaking too soon, but once the enemies go away, this is a much easier boss fight. Much easier boss fight. This must be only a challenge. I mean, it's... Oh man, if I was only playing melee, this would be a really hard fight. Large part of it is the crossbow. That is helping a ton. Because if I were just playing melee, I would not be able to deal with this easily. And we're going to have another butt stomp. Oh, wait, that's damage. That's what I mean. If I was melee, I would have to deal with the damage over time, and that would be a pain in the... Well, legs, primarily. Okay. Are those vulnerable, too? Oh. That top part is... Now it's lifting itself up again. Oh, no, it's... I've gotten very fortunate at this point. Really, this stage of the fight is just... If you're playing melee, it's a pain in the butt. If you're not playing melee, it's... considerably easier. Ow! Main reason being I can actually heal at this point. Like, I have the heal spell. This build is... surprisingly not that difficult, I guess. And you think, I have no shield. I'm supposed to have shield. This is Dark Souls, that's how it works, but nope! Oh boy. Ow! Oh, that's a corner. Oh, well, okay. On to run two. I'll skip past the run back as usual. Darn. See, that's why it's a hard fight for melee characters. If I was playing melee only, that'd be a pain in the butt. Alright, see you on the other side. Alright, back. So, yeah, this is, once again, let's try this again, but this time I'm a bit more confident, just because, oops, I was loaded. Shoot. Okay. Alright, can I hit the, I mean, I probably want to get rid of these little enemies first if I can. Ow. Ah, that's how to be out of energy. Stamina, rather. Seriously, you're gonna hit me that hard? This part of the fight's probably one of the more annoying parts, honestly. Just having to deal with these jokers over and over. I mean, and then finally the tree gets up, and then of course there's a bunch of enemies that are gonna come after me. Okay. Once again, no point in locking on. Thank you, tree. Seriously? This is the crossbows for. That and hitting the... Ah, kind of loud, it was loaded. Ow! That didn't actually hurt that much. Okay, I kind of want to keep the hands... vulnerable for a little while longer. There we go. Main body gone. Nope, foot's gonna take a little longer to get down. Butt stomp. Oh, already? Wow. Okay. I guess just take out the body and then immediately this happens and you get past... You don't have to worry about the small guys. The mooks are gone. The only downside being that I have more health to deal with right now. But I also have more polyps to deal with, so I guess it all evens out. Especially since now the football is going to be super vulnerable. But give me my souls first. Wow, there's a lot of stuff down here. This reminds me of the Calamite boss fight, where there's loads and loads of items you just pick up. Come on, get hit, get hit, get... Oh, seriously? I can deal with this. Oh, yeah! Don't crush me, that's all. That's all I ask. And of course, don't grab me either, please. That's also what I ask. Ah. This is gonna be... Okay, this part's gonna be tough again. But it's good to know, if I hit the middle, then I get down past the mook spot, because the mooks were the hardest thing I found to deal with. But you know what? I have renewed respect for this, just because... Before I said, what is this? Is this like that one... weird church boss fight in Brightstone Cove at Eldora, which was a real pain in the butt, because there was all these enemies. It was kind of crap. But this is different, because I can totally avoid it. I have much more respect for this. You know what? Just... I kind of wish I could... Whoa. Do wish I could... Ow. Run! Run away! Because that was a grab. Okay. As I was saying, I do kind of wish I could lock onto the limbs, though. I'm a little surprised I cannot do that. Okay, I'm not. There we go. That's not a polyp? Seriously, not a polyp, huh? Okay. What else can I hit? I've gotten rid of one of the hands. There's one of the legs is still left. The body is still there, but frankly, that's honestly too scary. Both frankly and honestly, it is too scary. I am being redundant in my intensifiers. That is how scary it is. Nope, that's not a vulnerable part, apparently. What about the areas really up top? Man, how do I get in this? Okay... Ow. I'm kind of keeping myself topped up in case I get grabbed, because I'm pretty sure I can survive a grab at full health. Just not, you know, below full health. There we go, that's what I was waiting for. Where's the... Oh, this isn't the one. Shoot, I got it wrong. This is the one. What? Okay, left leg. Gotta remember, left leg. If they fall over again like that, left leg is my target. This is... a really tricky fight. Not hard so much as just tricky. Because there aren't any easy ways of dealing damage. You have to hit these polyps. And like... How do I do that? Unless I is able to lock onto them or can shoot from the hip well enough, which... Not totally. Alright, you're gonna fall over? Please fall over. Ow! Well, I guess they... They acquiesced to my request, but that's not what I wanted. I wanted them to fall over, sure, but not on me. Nope, they grabbed me. Okay, can I survive at full health? I can! I got some weird status effect, though, and I'm not going to survive if anything else like that. So close. Man, that heart, that end bit. Let's just go from range. All right, once again, I will see you the next fight. I may even skip past the earlier sections. I don't know. All right, welcome back, Dark Souls fans. Back to the second stage. I have my Ember up just in case... Oh, no, wait. Shoot. Just in case I get grabbed, mostly. Oh, apparently Embering up also restores all my Estus. That's good to know. Oh. Oh, come on. Seriously, I can't get through. Wasn't in the right... Right, wasn't that the left leg, I mean. That's the important one. Although the back's still vulnerable. We're still at the early stages. Can still hit that back. Oh, of course it's gonna do the weird acid pool thing. Oops. Right, I'm getting in the habit of reloading periodically. I don't need to worry about the thing as much. Keeping it reloaded. Oh, maybe I can't hit those. Maybe they're just the weapons that it uses to try to hit me. Yeah, there we go! Oh wait, I can hit the back. Ah, seriously? Ow! No! Ow! Not what I wanted. What it wanted, not me. Okay. More falling damage from the sky. Nice! Crossbowed it out. And, oh, is someone on the right leg too? There was someone on the right leg! I didn't realize that! I did not see it! I was blind! I wonder if it randomizes. I noticed on the way in that the patrol routes of the enemies that I'm fighting on the way in are actually... Oh wait, that is left. Let's get my left and rights confused. But I noticed the patrol routes for enemies were actually different. Like, the actual enemies patrolling on the run back seem to have changed. Oops, nope. Which is interesting. I guess that means that there's some degree of randomization. Which is pretty cool. I mean, for enemy pattern kind of thing, it's one of those... One of those perennial complaints people have about Dark Souls is all the enemies are always the same. It gets kind of boring on runbacks. And, well, I guess they addressed that in 3. Alright, how are we gonna do this? Because I can't quite easily get in, and that arm... Man, figuring out the spacing of that arm is really tricky. Ow. Okay, running away again. Ah, come on! When am I supposed to heal up? I don't... This is gonna take all day. This is gonna be the episode, probably, most likely. I wanted to save you the time. Oh well. I'll save you the time of the run back, at least. there we go! Finally got rid of this thing. Far too many tries than is appropriate when doing a Let's Play series. Oh, what's this? Okay, so let's see what we just got. Let's see here. So, one of those is the soul, which is going to be in here. Let's read that, shall we? Have a bit of reading time, story time, bit of a slowing down after that intense set of boss fights. Well, attempts. Okay. Soul of the Cursed Rotted Greatwood, one of the twisted souls steeped in strength, used to acquire many souls, or transposed to extract its true strength. Ever since its establishment, all manner of curses have managed to seep into the undead settlement. The worst of them were sealed away inside a spirit tree, but eventually the curses took their toll. Oh, well, I guess it was a big cursed wood anyway. And transposing kiln. An old transposing kiln from Corland, crafted with stitched crystal lizard hide. Give to Lidlith, Lord of Cinder, to conduct soul transposition. This kiln can transpose twisted souls to craft special items with their concentrated essence, deemed forbidden by those unable to make proper use of it. Okay, gotta double check we have that one. We have a Lord of Cinder back home. I don't know which one, I'll have to double check. Hopefully it's Lidlith. And if so, then I guess we can do soul transposition, which is probably boss items. Homeward Bone, Sandy. Wargod Wooden Shield. Wooden shield reinforced with metal. Okay, the bizarre pattern featured on the shield is the mark of a mad god, revered as a god of war in remote regions. Oh, neat. So you can actually use the weapon skill for your main hand weapon with that. That's cool. But we're not using shields. Oh. So I might as well just sit rest of the bonfire, get out my Estus and everything. Yeah, I had to get my Ember restored halfway through because it was really hard with the amount of health I have. I might want to actually get more health. Oh, what's this? I deepened my allegiance to a covenant I've never found, but I guess... Oh, it's the Mold Mounds Covenant. But hey, killed one of their followers, I guess... Turnabout is fair play? I guess that's how it all works. And if I want more, I suppose I could just summon mad spirits and have them come after me. So... now what? I'm not going to go back just yet. I want to make sure that I haven't missed anything. No, that's unavailable. There's a lot of cages down here. I guess this is some kind of catacombs? I mean, we already saw before there are some kind of catacombs in the Undead Settlement. A bunch of skeletons and probably necromancers and other stuff. But I guess this is just more of the same. I mean, we did see the sacrificial altar and all the vertebrae and all the skulls. Pretty dead giveaway, all things considered. So, let's go back to Firelink Shrine. Now I'm not sure where to go. Unless now at this point we're going to get another place to go in our main little archstone. But first...
Welcome home, speak.
Actually, you know what? No. Want to know if something changed with you. Something changed with you.
At the foot of Lothric Castle, an old path still runs below the tower in the Undead Settlement. It was used to transport sacrifices to the Cathedral of the Deep. You should see where it leads. If you've the stones for it.
Okay, thanks for the hint. So this is Yorm, no. This is Watchers of the Abyss. Actually, let's just check which one we have already. If it's Lidlith, then we are all good. And it is Lidlith, okay. Ew.
Fret not, my feet are here firmly planted. For I am a lord, and this is my throne. Listen, this might pique thine interest. Before I was a Lord of Cinder, I was a student of transposition, the process of extracting and coalescing the essence of a soul. A forbidden art that once left a foul stain upon Corlan's honor.
'Tis an art that grants powers once thought unattainable. Most transposing kilns were lost with Corland, but this place is a crossing for all manner of cursed objects. If thou happenst upon a transposing kiln, bring it to me, quick. Oh, belike it is a transposing kiln in thy possession. Seen better days, but methinks it shall suffice. Now, bring to me a twisted soul. Transposition is the art of extracting and coalescing the essence of a soul. In transposing a twisted soul, its true power transferreth to thee. Thy purpose is to seek lords and slay them. What's to fear in a little transposition now?
Okay, so Rod of Greatwood gets me a greatsword? Oh, very dexterity-oriented greatsword. Okay. Get a hammer for Vort. Get a... What does this get? Oh, so another one. Spear is the other option. So, greatsword or spear? That's interesting. I might want to keep my eyes open for that, though I need a lot more dexterity. And a ring, which recovers HP with attacks. Heard about this ring. Apparently, it is basically...
Knowest thou of our five thrones?
Oh, right. I already talked to this. That was one of the first things I talked to you about. All right. So this ring is apparently the Bloodborne ring, as it's been often called. You attack and you regain health. I guess we might as well test it. Oh, right. This doesn't load until I get near it, does it? Just thinking, maybe I should test it with that enemy outside, the one that I couldn't beat in the first episode. Maybe we'll beat it finally, although I'll only take one shot, otherwise this episode might be getting a little long. There we go. Apparently, I looked it up. That just happens because it only loads the area you're in. That is, in fact, a loading screen, as I had initially suspected. I mean, it's kind of hard to tell when it's attacking. Because, whoa. Oh, you know what? Hang on, before I go and fight that thing, I just realized I've got a lot of souls. So I'll get back to that, I'll cut this out. Okay, there we go. Leveled up, one's in vigor, one's in endurance, so a bit more health, a bit more stamina. And my old foe is still here. Wow, they take a lot of punishment before going down. Even... Okay. Ow. I figured that would happen. Really? How much defense does this thing have? Okay, I'm gonna try one more time with my longsword instead of the claymore. I have a feeling that... Although I guess I can just switch between the two at will, but I have a feeling that's gonna be a thing. Like, it almost feels like it's not taking any more damage than it used to before. Unless there's something about that that it actually levels up as you do. Like, the more levels you get, the more levels it gets, the more defense it gets. That'd be kind of weird. I honestly expected to be able to kill it pretty much easily. But I guess that's not on the table. Also, I'm kind of curious if that ring that I mentioned, if that works by... Oh, darn it. I never know when I'm loaded. Oh, come on! I need to hit... Okay, I'll try until I actually hit with a crossbow. I mean, sorry, hit with a longsword. Because there's no point trying if I'm not going to even hit. I don't even know what damage it's going to do. Hey. So it deals more damage with the longsword? Weird. And it also stuns out better, too. Huh, really? Compared to the claymore? Oh, no. What the? Okay, don't know what happened before, but whatever it was. Man or now, Tugatana, Master's Attire, Master's Gloves. What are these? Do these do something special? Master's Attire. Men are terribly fond of weaving tales to explain the ragness of their garb. My sixth sense warned me of danger, and I danced between flurries of blades unscathed, but alas, my clothes went to tatters. And no, that wasn't it, that was the gloves. Is it the same thing? Yeah, it's the same one. So, what were they guarding? Does not open from this side! Okay, well, that was... I mean, I got 2,000 souls, I guess that was okay. Would have been nicer to have actually won right at the start, but whatever, it's dead. At least for now, it'd probably respawn knowing how this game works. Oh, what's this? Huh. Okay, I have no idea how this works now. And apparently successive attacks caused me to regain health, so... I don't know. It's not like Bloodborne, it's not rally mechanic, it's something a bit different. Anyway, that's gonna be it for this episode. I managed to, with some difficulty, get through two rather difficult enemies. And now I've gotta figure out where the heck to go next. Something about something below the Undead Settlement? I don't know. I'll go back to the pit and maybe something will show up. So, thanks for watching, and until the next episode, have a good night.